planet's past, and it's happening again now.
Question of will sea level rise a large amount? Past that will occur.
Sea levels rise foot by foot.
The world by 2100.
Our greatest challenge yet. New York, the 24th century. Sea levels have risen by 120 feet. Scenario. The world has vast amounts of frozen water to more than 2 miles thick. Want to know how much frozen water the continent actually holds? How much global sea levels would rise if all of this ice melted? The bedrock and measuring the depth of the ice sheets. Antarctica contains over 90% of the world's ice. Together, 230 feet. North America would look like if all of the planet's ice melted. France. Is sea level rise reality or myth? Professor is a paleontologist and astrobiologist. Foot by foot. He's planet. Below sea level are banks of coral. Fishes have been at this location for over 4,000 years. During it's an abandoned quarry.
Yeah.
Position, grew straight up.
Very nice.
Here at a very young 23 years of age, our professor brought us to this quarry and said, grow straight up. Living in place. Here, there's not been any volcanism. Nothing has lifted Florida up. This coral, this high up in the air now, at least another 10 feet above this. Me, that sea level, which I knew had gone down and come up, it is now.
Our coastal cities would be inundated. It's past. Ice Age. And sea levels fell. Receded. Huge amounts of fossil fuels. So do sea levels.
Carbon dioxide. And it -5 degrees centigrade warming in this century, sea level rises and faster as we heat up the planet more.
Storff's climate model predicts a maximum 6-foot sea level rise this century, as one face inundation this century is Miami in southern Florida, just a few feet above sea level, and has virtually no defenses against a rising ocean. At high tide, inundated, and struck land. Coastal real estate would be ruined.
Millions and millions and millions of dollars of real estate here. Hundred here, we've got 100 area through here. 1 meter, 3 feet of sea level rise. Who's gonna buy them? By the time we get 3 feet, I mean, just you. That's what will happen. I'll just be left here.
Not just
owed all the goods and services. single one of those ports has to be replaced. Infrastructure that
rise. Electricity supplies would be affected. Feet. Some of Florida's fresh water supply would be contaminated with seawater. Everglades National Park becomes a vast bay. The state.
Be at least 4 to 6 feet higher. High tide will be about here, up to here. Back as it rises, diminished. The kind of sea level rises we're in for.
The expensive system of levees surrounding the city. It would allow seawater to seep through. If Miami was flooded, the city would eventually have to be abandoned.
Based on, can we dike it off, can we put it off, or not worth the price, not worth the effort.
A coast. Hurricane Katrina in 2005, large parts of New Orleans were flooded. A storm surge raised sea levels by 20 feet. Levees weren't strong enough to hold back the rising sea. And onwards into the city's canals. 50 places.
Flood walls that failed caused massive flooding throughout the city. 10% of the city of New Orleans was flooded following Hurricane Katrina.
It's Taylor and her son Peter.
See about our house. My heart a little bit because my come in again. I might panic this time. I don't know. The swallow, you see.
Dollars in the city's sea defenses. The U.S. Army Corps of Engineers is strengthening New Orleans levees and locks.
into the designs for the Greater New Orleans Hurricane Storm Damage Risk Reduction System. Flood walls, it has pump stations, it has levees, the series that we call the multiple lines of defense.
A lagoon to the east of New Orleans. The Corps of Engineers is focusing its efforts.
We've 8 miles away from the 9th Ward, which was flooded. Found the heart of the city, left it in there, improved it. 8 miles out to the edge of Lake Bourne. Brand new structure which works as a primary line of defense.
These impressive sea defenses in 2 years' time. In some of its top people.
Kosovo, Kuwait twice, and Iraq three times. To help rebuild the city.
One rising oceans.
River and built up down here. The better it is to grow something on, the worse it is to build on. Possible stuff to build in. It is the Hawken. It is a pile driving crane brought in from Seattle, Washington. Gate. 50 feet through the newer material down to the old Pleistocene clay, and that is our base. Main wall itself goes down to minus 130 feet, and the batter piles that brace it are down to 190 feet. Everything is based upon piles.
As allow ships to pass through. $15 billion. But then sea levels. If as well. Not just above sea level. Effect on the country's population.
The area of the world that would be most vulnerable to sea level rise would be Asia. Sea level. But half the rice land in Bangladesh underwater.
And that number is rising fast. It gets covered by water. 3-foot sea level rise wipes out half its rice crop, a third, and their land is being shrunk by a third. You know, you do the math. It's a catastrophe coming at us.
Sea level rise would be a disaster.
It's probably at least a few tens of millions of people. Bangladesh. Looking for a place to go. The countries on Earth. Deltas in Asia.
Lines around the world will be under siege from the rising tides. But to rise at an even faster rate. Antarctica accelerates. About the speed of future sea level rise can be found in the planet's past, of the last ice age. As rose, the planet's ice sheets melted into the sea. First slowly, then at great speed, by a staggering 390 feet. How fast did this happen? Rise in the next century. Leading experts on past sea level rise. He in the thousands of years ago.
I have two pieces of fossil coral that was recovered from drill cores off of Barbados. Were retrieved. Point reconstruction of sea level for the last 20,000 years. Call it Meltwater Pulse 1A. Sea level rose about 20 meters in 500 years per 100 years.
Happened again. It in the next century. And faster rises.
Under control, the rate of sea level rise will keep accelerating. So in the next century, it's not only that we get the additional 7 feet that we got the last century, that's going to happen. Looking by 2200, and probably 20, that they are doomed.
Feet per century, followed by Miami.
Off in New Orleans, those are two cities that will have to be abandoned, I imagine.
San Francisco Bay Area, with its 7.5 million people.
vulnerable to sea level rise because of our history. Big, it's very shallow. Two-thirds of it was less than 12 feet deep. Reclaimed land, district is on reclaimed land. In America is at the Golden Gate.
People would be in danger of losing their homes in the Bay Area. Levees would have to be built on a massive scale.
So many jobs. ...of the world by 2100, I think. Worldwide, we're gonna have a damn revolution.
To be defended with levees. Delta in the east would remain vulnerable. Fertile farmland.
The important part is food. A portion of human food that comes from land that is at sea level. By sea level rising. Fields next to it, even if they're not covered by the sea. Human crops by the sea.
Were lost to the sea. American West Coast.
Of California's water supply. This estuary. Huge number, two-thirds of the population of California gets water from this estuary. What? You know, which... Yeah. Will salt up this end of the delta.
The local rivers would be contaminated with salt. Supply would be lost. After an additional 16 feet, defending both the Delta and San Francisco Bay.
Most
...30 feet deep. Freshwater lagoon. May be considered the lesser of two evils. The Delta would be using cutting-edge technology. Huge dredgers could pick up sand from the seabed nearby, Station. The against earthquakes. Dam would cost $2.5 billion, including locks, tightened to deal with any sea level rise of the future. One Mediterranean. By countries both rich and poor that have thousands of years of history. Rise. Percent of the country's economy is based on tourism. Economy would nosedive.
For the industry, for the tourist industry. Readapt to the new conditions. Structure like this. And in such a scenario, most of the beach will disappear.
Like Miami and New Orleans, Barcelona has hills to retreat to. If sea levels rose an additional 16 feet in the next century, severely affected.
Huge change in the society, a huge change for the population in terms of way of living. So now we are enjoying our waterfront. For an extreme scenario, it will be really different. We have to adapt to the new situation.
The short-term predictions of 6 feet of sea level rise this century, which port may soon be obsolete. Barcelona would be flooded. That would suffer over the next centuries. To Africa. Separate from the Med.
This is World War II, for instance, to put a dam and Morocco on the African side. Sea level rise does not affect the Mediterranean.
Here, the Med loses 2 feet of sea level through evaporation. Inflow of water from the Atlantic. The dam would cut this off.
Straits, there will not be the flow of water from the Atlantic. Cut the flow. There will be a permanent drop of the water level.
Years of evaporation, the Med would turn into a stagnant salt lake. The sea would dry out.
Water would rise.
Peter Janssen.
I might be required to make a closure. Well, I thought it may be feasible.
Gate. 150 feet above the seabed. In and outflow of the Gibraltar Straits going. Water will be allowed to flow into the Med. Saltier water will be pumped back out again. Sea levels are kept stable. 275 billion dollars. Structure. The Med and the Atlantic. Flooding.
Technologically possible, the old cradle of civilization becomes really the center of civilization.
Super dams. Lost to the sea. That are too poor to build defenses are flooded. A country that would struggle to survive if sea levels rose by an additional 16 feet. The Netherlands.
Finger in the dike story, dealing with the problem of sea level in their country.
Just op het ogenblik dat ons land zich zo goed mogelijk hersteld had.
When a massive storm destroyed their sea defenses in 1953, large parts of the country were flooded, and almost 2,000 people drowned. Have turned the Netherlands into a fortress against the sea.
About how to wall off the sea. Wall a dike that we used to think of.
That by the 23rd century, our ice sheets will be melting at an even faster rate than before. Population.
Food, obviously, and want transportation. Emission usage are just adding back to what we've cut away.
Leading scientists believe that our CO2 level last had over 50 million years ago. And when sea levels were more than 230 feet higher than today.
carbon dioxide increases to more than 1,000 parts per million. Question, we will melt all the ice on the planet. There are almost 250-foot rise in sea level. The forcing of humans is so large that it will scale of centuries, I believe.
That would struggle to defend itself is London. Levels vary by up to 22 feet. City against storm surges from the sea. The barrier closes its gates and inner London is protected. Have to be replaced by a huge seawall upstream. But sea defenses.
I do not want to go down that path.
At a growing rate.
The world. Say it's going to be okay and trying to get out of there without drowning. Of civilization.
Landmarks would become a solemn outpost in the sea.
A degree of panic that we cannot imagine. Survive.
Obsolete levees, strengthen seawalls, large parts of continental Europe, Denmark, the Netherlands,
forever.
Within centuries, the sea it would creep up the River Seine and find its way to Paris. 15 feet, the French capital would be extremely vulnerable to sea level rise.
Their borders against millions and millions of areas most severely affected. With migration on this scale are unimaginable.
The world back by the rising oceans. vulnerable to sea level rise.
Rapidly. The city has two options: evacuating the city and its population to higher ground.
First in a series of catastrophic events. Be flooded. Times Square.
Sea levels rising 250 feet. Lapping around the roadway.
Even to extreme sea level rise.
Design floating apartment buildings.
Concrete sponge.
We don't have to protect them from nature. Just go up and down with the water.
Districts to be attached to it.
We're going to build a new Wall Street around it, around Manhattan. Redesign the city around it, or even having floating leisure around it, floating agriculture.
Is still at the concept stage. Hundreds of coastal cities facing inundation.
Of the whole thing to me is that it will require a united world. Enabling governments to act together. The boundary is, it's an equal opportunity flutter. We have to, as a planet, come at this in a united fashion.
Super dams. Humans will need all their ingenuity to meet the world's greatest challenge yet.